It's a humbling reality to think that God, in His divine purpose, has chosen to use us to introduce people to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, and then see them grow towards spiritual maturity. It all happens because the Word of God is taught. The Word of God is inherently powerful. The Apostle Paul spoke to his friend Timothy and reminded him that it was the Scriptures by which Timothy, as a boy, was made wise unto salvation. A few verses later in 2 Timothy chapter 3, Paul wrote again and said this, "All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be perfect or complete," that is, spiritually mature, "thoroughly furnished or equipped for every good work." Imagine that. When we teach the Word of God, people come to know the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior, and they grow in their faith towards spiritual maturity. Over the years of pastoral ministry, and then more recently in my role coming alongside of churches to help them be effective in their teaching ministries, I've come to some conclusions based on the Word of God about the importance of a teaching ministry within the church. I wrote a book called Strong Church, and in it I identify three essentials that must be in place within a church as it begins to move people towards spiritual maturity. Number one is to have a robust understanding and definition of spiritual maturity, again, based upon the Word of God. When I talk about a robust definition of spiritual maturity, I'm talking about things like this, that the Word of God is used to introduce people to a saving faith initially in Jesus Christ. Once they're saved, to begin that process of spiritual development and growth, helping them, for instance, to understand biblical ethics, that is, to grow in their understanding of right and wrong from God's perspective and the kind of conduct that is pleasing to God, to grow in their understanding so that they begin to internalize godliness. That means to share a growing relationship with Jesus Christ, an intimacy and personal walk with God, to learn doctrine so that they're firm in their convictions, grounded on the Word of God and not tossed about by every wind of doctrine that comes along, that they develop life skills, because almost every day life throws at us different challenges, and we have to be prepared to face them as God would desire. And then that we begin to reach out with the love and mercy of Christ to uplift others and encourage them. And finally, to help people be prepared to serve God in works of faith and ministry within the local church. All of that is part and parcel of what a robust understanding of spiritual maturity is all about. But then to go along to a second essential, and that is to assess where people are in their developmental process towards spiritual maturity. How much have they grown in the faith to be like Jesus Christ? Once we're able to assess where people are at, then we're able to move along to the third essential, and that is to be able to develop action plans to creatively and in a personal way move people from where they are in their walk with God on toward that ultimate goal of spiritual maturity. It's all part of that humbling reality that God has chosen to use us to teach His Word. You're a teacher of God's Word. I trust you'll use every opportunity you can to grow in your skills and competency of teaching the whole counsel of God in order that people might grow in their faith. Take a look at this book, Strong Church, and maybe it'll help you in the work God's called you to do. God bless you.